Hydrogen. What is the atomic number of hydrogen? What is the position of hydrogen atom? Incredible. Position of hydrogen atom is pretty big.
It's above alkali metals, but it's not
as
inclusive.
So they
put it
on top.
Is it an alkali metal?
No.
No. Why?
No.
Because it's like a halogen.
Huh?
Yeah.
Why it is not an alkali metal? It is not an alkali metal. Why? Because the definition of alkali metal is these are the metal which reacts with water and forms hydroxide. Like suppose Na is an alkali metal, reacts with water and forms hydroxide. NaOH plus half of H2. Proceed. Okay. So this kind of reaction hydrogen does not show. Okay, it does not react with water. Okay?
So but that's because it's already hydrogen.
So the definition of alkali metal is these are the metals which react with water, but hydrogen does not react. That's why it is not an alkali metal. Okay, that's the definition.
If any,
what?
So that's why any does react with any.
Water with NA reactor. NA will not react with this. Ah,
so even if hydrogen reacts with H2O, it will still get hydrogen and H2O.
No, it won't get. Or reaction over any.
So but
reaction is not possible. See why this reaction takes place is the reason NA gives NA plus plus one electron, right? And then this H2O from this OH minus will get attached to this. Okay, hydrogen does not react with water. That's the one thing. See, the point is the position of hydrogen atom, it is placed in the first group on the top, right? These are the elements, right? Why hydrogen is placed here? Because if you see the property of hydrogen, it has only one electron in the outermost shell, right? It has tendency to gain electron, gain one electron and forms doublet. It has tendency to release one electron, right? It has tendency to share electron. All three possibilities are there, right? So if you see these three properties, alkali metal has tendency to release one electron. Sodium, right? It releases one electron. This property is similar to halogens. This property is similar to alkali metal. And this property is similar to carbon family. Right? So we have three different, the position of hydrogen can be here with halogens or with alkali metals or with carbon family. Why it is placed in group 1? Because its outermost electronic configuration is what? 1s1. Since the electronic configuration is similar to that of other alkali metals, that's why it is placed in group 1. Okay? So this is placed in group 1, but it is not an alkali metal. That's the one thing. In NCERT, it is given. I'm not discussing this, just you just go through it. That there are few properties it has similar to that of halogens. Halogens ke liye just say halogens has property to gain one electron, high electronegativity. Hydrogen also has tendency to gain one electron, right? Yes, and halogens are diatomic also. F2, H2 will write F2, Cl2, Br2 like that. Hydrogen also diatomic, H2, right? Similarly for alkali metals also, hydrogen has few properties similar to alkali metals, like it is electropositive in nature. This is also electropositive, right? So like that, there are many properties which are similar. Reducing character is also there, right? And few properties similar to that of electro. So there are few properties which is similar to that of halogens, alkali metals, and carbon family. It is given in NCERT. Just go through once. Not that important. Okay. What we have to discuss here is the preparation of hydrogen, methods of preparation of hydrogen, and then chemical properties of this and few compounds of hydrogen. The most important part of this chapter is hardness. Okay, hardness is what? What is the hard? What is hard water and soft water? Right. So there are some reasons for hardness of water: temporary hardness and permanent hardness. What is the reason for that? And what is the removal? How to remove the hardness of water? Right. So if you have 5 minutes, suppose before the exam, and if you want to revise this chapter, you should revise hardness part of it. That is, mostly you'll get questions from there. Okay. And then some structure of H2O2, that is it for this chapter. So write down next the preparation of hydrogen. The first method is by the action of water on active metal. Write down first one, by the action of water on alkali metals.
This is reaction of hydrogen.
Preparation of hydrogen. By the action of water on alkali metals. Alkali metals, you can also take alkaline earth metals, active metals you can taste. Write on. The elements of group 1 and 2 reacts with water and evolves hydrogen gas. Okay. Reacts with water and evolves hydrogen gas. Next line. The reaction is exothermic in nature. To slow down the reaction, we use amalgam. Amalgam means the metal that we are using, amalgam of that, alloy with HG. Okay, so amalgam we use because the reaction is highly exothermic and very fast also. Okay, amalgam actually, see, you have metal, right? So it occupies the surface of the metal. Okay, it's adsorbed, I suppose. Hg get adsorbed on the surface of this. So active surface area decreases in this case. That's why the rate of the reaction also decreases. The reaction slows down. Okay?
So isn't that the same as putting in less metal? As in like more metal plus amalgam? Is
active metal plus amalgam, right?
Yeah.
So you have, suppose the active metal is not there, plus amalgam. So the rate of the, so that won't react at all.
No, but this just decreases the surface area.
Right.
Isn't that the same as just putting in lesser of the same metal without amalgam? As in, if you have more surface area plus amalgam.
No, that reaction is also possible. What happens? Reaction is highly exothermic and rigorous in nature. So it's very difficult to control. There are chances of catching fire also in that reaction because of high heat evolves. To control that reaction, we use amalgam here. So that the reaction slows down, lesser energy evolves, and we can control that. For that purpose, we are using. Without amalgam also, without HG alloy also, the reaction possible, but the rate is very high. Okay, next point you write down. By alkali solution, metals like beryllium, zinc, aluminium. Metals like beryllium, zinc, aluminium react with boiling alkali solution, means at high temperature. We heat the solution, boiling alkali solution, and evolves hydrogen gas.
So what do you mean metals like beryllium, zinc, and aluminium?
What kind
of category is
that? Generally, metals of group 1 you can take, or group. Generally, we'll take elements of group 2 or group 1 metal. It's active metals. Okay. So, second group, beryllium with NaOH, alkali solution. What it forms? H2 gas goes out and it forms sodium beryllate, Na2BeO2. This is sodium beryllate and H2 gas evolves into this. If you take aluminium, it forms sodium aluminate.
So is it because the metal is amphoteric?
What?
So is it due to the amphoteric nature of beryllium and aluminium?
Amphoteric nature is not required here because we are not using acid here. Only basic solution we have.
Okay.
what happens, this actually this beryllium can displace this hydrogen. Depends upon the electrode potential, which we haven't discussed here, electrochemistry we haven't discussed here. It can displace hydrogen gas from this. Next line down, by the action of acid on certain metals. By the action of acids on certain metals. By the action of certain metals on acid. Right on. There are certain metals which displaces hydrogen gas from the dilute acid solution.
So can you repeat action of
acids? By the action of acids on certain metals. There are certain metals which displaces hydrogen gas from the dilute acid solution. Okay, for example, zinc plus H2SO4. What is the product here? We can have Mg plus 2HCl. See, these metals are electropositive metals. These are electropositive metal. These metals are placed above hydrogen in the electrochemical series. Okay, electrochemical series, again we'll discuss this in electrochemistry. Somewhere in between we have electrode potential of hydrogen electrode, which is assumed to be zero. Okay, assumed to be zero, and above this we have positive electrode potential, E naught greater than 0, and below this E naught is less than 0. So we can take all those metals which has positive electrode potential, which and those metals can displace hydrogen from this dilute acid solution. All these are dilute acid solution. So this gives you ZnSO4 plus H2, MgCl2 plus H2.
So what's the difference between this series and the reactivity series?
Reactivity series of what?
Metals.
See, difference is not there, but we can use this series, this reactivity with respect to dilute acid if you see. I'll explain this what happens here. See, actually hydrogen is present here. One thing is there that if electrode potential is more, then that metal has more tendency to go under reduction. Electrode potential means reduction potential. Okay, so if you have two metals, suppose M1 and M2, if M1 has more electrode potential than M2, and if you form a cell of these two electrodes, in this M1 will be the reduction electrode where the reduction takes place, which is cathode, and M2 will be oxidation, right? So what happens here, Zn+2, you see the oxidation state of zinc is zero here. Here it is +2, hydrogen is +1, and here it is 0. So which one is going under oxidation and which one is going under reduction? Zn is getting oxidized and hydrogen is getting reduced. Right. So what we can say, when zinc reacts with this, it displaces hydrogen, right, and goes under oxidation. It means we can write the E naught of Zn+2 to Zn, that is the reduction potential +2 to 0, is less than, E naught is less, that's why it is going, is getting oxidized. It is less than the E naught of H+2. Can be negative, can be positive, depends upon the metal. There are certain metals which has negative electrode potential. Certain metals have positive electrode potential. Means this reaction means all those metals whose reduction potential is lesser than to that of hydrogen can displace hydrogen from its dilute acid. Okay, one thing I wrote here wrong, this should be negative and this should be positive. Okay, so reactivity series is this only. When you have metals which has more oxidation potential, that will displace the other metal from its dilute solution. That is a reactivity series. More reduction potential, more reactivity, more tendency towards the reduction reaction of that. Okay?